Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, a space about mindful living, general well-being and healthy food. In today's video I'm going to share with you 20 things that I do to keep my immune system strong. So if you are interested, stay tuned. Number 1. At least twice a month, if not more often, I try to wash my feet with hot water and I add a little bit of vapor. I found this helps release some of that steam and it's a very good anti-congestion. So I really like the steam, my feet stay warm, and I help my body by keeping my extremities warm without having to do so much work, which in turn actually helps my body to use that energy on other things that it might need, such as perhaps fighting infections or any virus or bacteria that might have been able to lurk inside my body. Number 2, I try to keep my oral hygiene as best as I can. I aim to do gargles at least once a week, if no more, and that also goes with scraping my tongue. This is not something that I was used to doing before, but since I found this tongue scraper, I actually have been using it quite often, and I think that it has helped me to not develop as many sore throats as I used to have. I know there can be other causes and reasons of the work that is happening. However, I find that if I scrape my tongue in the morning and before bedtime, I get rid of quite a lot of gunk that could have accumulated throughout the day and throughout the night on my tongue. And it just helps keep my breath clean, as well as I eliminate any possible bacteria that could have grown from that. Number 3, as I wake up, I try to drink warm water with either lemon or lime juice. I find this helps move things along and it just helps me start the day in a fresh way. Number 4, this is something that I do not do as often, but I try to do as much as I can, especially on those times when I feel that there's a cold maybe trying to settle in me, or that I'm feeling a little bit run down. This is something that I drink, and it's golden milk, not only with turmeric but also with ginger, cinnamon, honey and lemon. This not only provides a great amount of vitamins for the body, it's also a very good anti-inflammatory. So whenever I'm also feeling bloated, this is my first go-to drink. Number 5, I pay attention to my sleep. Our bodies need plenty of time to restore our system and recover from our busy day lives. I personally prefer quality versus quantity, but the recommended amount of hours to sleep is said to be 8 hours. And everybody is different. It might be that you work well with 7 hours more than you work with 8 hours, or it could be that you need 9 hours rather than 8. It all depends on the individual circumstances. Number 6, breathe through your nose instead of your mouth. Breathing through our mouths can bring in cold, unfiltered air into our lungs, which can cause ailments and poor overall health in the long run. I will highly recommend you read the book Breath by James Nestor. In this book, the author makes several researches in which he is determined to find out what the true difference is between breathing through our nose than breathing through our mouths. And it's very interesting, all the evidence and all the research that has been piled into this book. Number 7, I try to slow down if I am feeling either stressed, anxious or aggravated. And you can do several techniques in order to help yourself with this. One of the best techniques that I have found is the breathing technique. And that is just when you breathe in the count of 4, you hold for 4, you release through your mouth in 4, and then you wait for 4 before you take your next breath. I found that just helps me to settle down, calm down, and be able to think better. You could also try starting a gratitude journal, or just following good news online, you know, especially nowadays where all the stuff that is happening around the world, it just can be quite negative sometimes. So I find that trying to, apart from these relaxation techniques, just try to find the good and the positive out of my life and out of the world, just to help me see the world in a better outlook. There's great groups that you can find on Instagram. One of them is called Good News Movement, of course, between others. Number 8. I give time to myself. Our busy day lives just leaves us with little to no time whatsoever for anything that is related to us. We live in a society where we go to work 4 to 8 hours a day, if no more. We leave commuting, we eat on the go, we find little time for relaxation, we are filled with commitments throughout our whole days. If I do not find that little 5-minute gap, 10-minute gap, maybe 1-hour gap here, on the everyday basis, I feel myself so overwhelmed and run down, and I feel that I haven't done anything for myself. A happy me is a better me, and I just want to be the best version of myself. When I am happy, I feel stronger, and I also feel my immune system is reacting in a better positive way. Rather than when I'm run down and I know that I haven't done anything for myself, it just creates more stress within me, which at the same time lets me more run down and more likely to catch an illness. Number 9, I have stopped meat consumption. In between of the reasons of why this is good, research has been done in the links between red meat consumption and the brain functionality, and that is just due to the high levels of saturated fat present in red meat, as well as cheeses, for example. There's an interesting book called Diet for the Mind by Dr. Martha Morris, which I'll suggest you read if you're more interested to find about the effects on diet and the mind and how they play together. As well, there are other documentaries on Netflix which are actually very interesting. One of them is called The Game Changers, another one is called Cowspiracy, and another one is called What the Health. They're all documentaries based on research, so you do your own research and decide for yourself what's best for you. Number 10, I consume less processed foods, not only to rid my body from added salt, sugar, fats and additives that my body doesn't require, but also just to feel a sense of cleansing in the body. Quite a lot of these things are present in our nowadays food whenever we go shopping, especially in those items that are already pre-made for us, because they need to last long on the shelves so that we can actually still enjoy them by the time we decide to buy them. And even when you buy them, you can see the expiry date. Sometimes it lasts like a month after, or even if it is a week after. When you are constantly cooking meals at home, you realize how long is the food actually lasting in the fridge in perfect storage conditions. So it just makes you realize how many additives are being added to this food to make it last for that long on a shelf waiting for someone to pick it up and eat it. Now instead, I'm just trying to increase the consumption of those things that are whole, that are plant-based ideally, and that are high in fiber, vitamins, minerals, just everything that the body needs without the added extras. Another interesting book that I have come across is this one by Michael Moss. It's very interesting to find out all the stuff that goes in the food that we eat nowadays. So if you want to find out a little bit more of that, I suggest that you read this book, especially if you are concerned in salt, sugar and fats added to food. Number 11, another thing that I do is try to keep my gut happy and healthy, and that is by trying to reduce or minimize as much as I can the bad bacteria and try to increase that which is good. Normally the foods that tend to help our gut bacteria are those that we normally don't eat as much as we should. Things like leafy greens, fermented foods, kefir, probiotics, good amount of fruits as well, and just less processed foods overall. Number 12, I pay attention to my bowel movements and listen to my body cues. A healthy bowel movement is considered anything between 1 and 3 times per day. Anything less could be a sign of constipation, which is something that needs to be tended to. Not only because it can cause pain, it can become really uncomfortable, but also because it can create intoxication within the body due to a clogged system. Number 13, lacking vitamins can lead us to body imbalances, as well as can make us feel unwell. If you think you may need help here, I suggest you go and visit your doctor to see what tests can be done and to find out exactly what is it that you need. Number 14, I can see that sunshine to be one of the best free medicines out there. It not only helps us release happy hormones, it also helps keep our bodies, teeth, bones and immune system strong. Number 15, I personally like to use garlic and honey ferments. This type of traditional remedies has been used for quite a long time, and it's something that can be used for its antibacterial, antiviral, as well as immune boosting benefits. Number 16, I use laughter as a preventive medicine. I'm a strong believer that there's a body and mind connection, and a healthy mind in a happy body will exist, as well as a happy body in a healthy mind. There's research that has been done that people who laugh with others tend to live longer, healthier lives. Number 17, I pay more attention as to if my diet is more alkaline or acidic. I came across this book which is called Healing Psoriasis by Dr. John Pagano. And in this book you can find research that suggests that most of our diets nowadays are acidic forming. And the more acidic our bodies are, the easier it is for bacteria and illnesses to proliferate and take over. Keeping our body strong and gravitating towards a more alkaline state will help us combat most of the normal colds and flus. However, not all of them, but the best we can do is to try to keep our bodies as healthy as we can. Number 18. I take control over that which worries me a lot and is constantly on my mind. I believe strongly that stress is one of the precursors of most of today's ailments. Of course, not all of them, but quite a lot of them are due to high levels of stress within ourselves. We don't have enough ways to de-stress, to let go of some of that steam that we're building ourselves into. And quite often, when our buckets are filled with stress, without any means of that escaping in a healthy way, it's just when our bodies become tired, become less able to do its job properly, because we're often required quite a lot of effort and attention with our worries. I am trying desperately to teach myself to stop worrying about things over which I have no control. Besides, if there's something that I can do about it, then why do I worry? And if there isn't anything I can do whatsoever to fix an outcome, then why do I worry? It's just living in this constant bubble of stress and anxiety that I tend to create for myself without an actual need for it. Number 19, I use an oil diffuser to set the mood and also to have some free thinking me time. I normally use this when I'm sitting down at night once the kids have gone to bed, and I just like to see the changing colors or maybe just a special aroma that I have created in that room helps me to relax and unwind after a long busy day. Number 20, this can be used as preventive as it can be used once you are already ill, if you have a cold or a flu or sinuses, and that is to use a bowl with hot vapor in it to create a sauna effect only for your head, so that it can help to decongest all the airways and help you breathe easier. The hot steamy air is something that I'm not very keen on particularly, but I know that it really helps, especially on those times when I'm feeling my nose and my sinuses are getting congested, either due to allergy or pollution, or just because I'm running down with something. I feel this actually helps me clear my airways and helps me recover that a little bit faster. So that is it, my 20 tips, things that I do to keep my immune system strong. I hope that you liked this video. If you did, please make sure that you subscribe to my channel. It will really help me and will keep me motivated to keep creating content like this. I hope I see you in my next video. Until then, stay strong, healthy, and happy.